at solid blending. Now, when it comes to solid blending, there are, you know, flow currents don't really exist in solid blending. And in solid blending, there are three primary mechanisms whereby the blending takes place. So there is, what you see here is a V blender in operation, and it works on the principle of diffusion blending. Now, diffusion blending is characterized by a small-scale random movement of the material, and this random movement is caused by the action of the blender mobility. So over a period of time, the mixing would be fairly homogeneous, and in the absence of segregation, you could get excellent homogeneity to the tune of 98 to 99%. But the challenge is, when it comes to diffusion blending, is that materials which are cohesive, or when you have different materials having different particle sizes, different bulk densities, that's when the diffusion blending would not be adequate. And then you would come to something like convective mixing. So what you see there is a parallel blender in operation, which is a convective type of a mixer, and it creates bulk motion. The bulk motion is created by the action of the mixing impellers, and over a period of time, you know, the effects of cohesiveness, the densities, they all tend to kind of get evened out, and by convective mixing you are able to get a homogeneous blend. The third mechanism is shear. Now, you have substances which might have agglomerates. Now, breaking down the agglomerates is what happens with shear mixing. So you would have high intensifier bars or choppers which would disintegrate the lumps, and then in combination with convective mixing, you could get a uniform blend. So what you see there is a plowshare mixer, and although the simulation of the choppers has not been shown, but that's what happens with solid blending. So solid blending, flowability of material is fairly good, and that's what therefore helps solid blending. It is not as well documented as liquid blending, but fairly well established.